James 1. It's the back of the book. The back. If you get to 1 John, you've gone too far. Next to Hebrews is right. Amen.
Amen.
All those who have it say yay.
Yay.
Okay. Amen. I'm going to be reading from the King James Version. And again, it's James chapter 1, verses 2 through 7. This is about faith and humility. My brethren, count it all joy. Somebody say all.
All.
All joy.
All joy.
All joy when you fall into diverse temptations.
Yes.
Knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience.
Amen.
But let patience have her perfect work, that ye may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. If any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, that giveth to all men, say all men liberally, and upbraideth not, and it shall be given him. But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. For he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea, driven with the wind and tossed. For let not that man think that he shall receive anything of the Lord. For a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. Amen. Because we know that what faith without works is dead. Dead. In fact, in James 2, 14 to 17, you don't have to turn there, but it does say, what good is it, my brother, if a man says that he has faith but has no works? Can faith save him? And if a brother or sister is naked and in lack of daily food, and one of you tells them, go in peace, be warm and filled, and you don't give them the things that they need, what good is it? Even so, faith, if it has no works, is dead in itself. Now, we know that the testing of our faith produces perseverance or patience.
Yeah.
Patience. A lot of us don't have that. In this age of technology, we want things right away. Right away. Well, I don't want to wait in line. I'm in a hurry. Can't you see I'm in a hurry? You got 12 things in your cart. I only got one. Can't you let me in? We see this all the time. It's a testing of our faith. Because God wants us, yes, he wants us to find joy in the midst of our trials. But how am I going to find joy? I'm going through a hard time, you say. But he's not going to say be joyful about the trial itself. Be joyful in the midst. Find joy to reason, or the reason to praise God while you're going through it. You're going to be purified. You're going to find the faith. That faith is going to be purified. See, sometimes we got some selfish motives and misguided direction.
Amen.
God needs to get us back on track. God uses trouble and trial and tribulations and trials to get us back on track.
Amen.
Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
He uses it. But that's how he's going to refine you like gold.
Amen.
Like pure gold. So we see in verse 4, that perseverance must finish its work, so that we may be mature and complete, not lacking in anything. Somebody say anything. Not lacking in anything.
Amen.
So he says, ask. In verse 5, he says, ask for wisdom. Ask for wisdom. Myself, I can use myself. I have asked for the wisdom of Solomon.
Amen.
I asked for the wisdom, and guess what? He's going to give to you. He's going to give to you his children. He is going to give to you when you ask for wisdom. Lord, help me know. I don't know what to do in this situation, but Lord, just give me wisdom.
Amen.
Guess what he's going to give you, Donald? He's going to give you wisdom.
Amen.
He's going to give you wisdom. I didn't ask for riches. I didn't ask for the biggest mansion on the east side. I asked for wisdom. Amen. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. It will be given to you.
Amen.
But this is the but. The believer needs to ask for wisdom. We need to believe and not doubt that he is going to give us wisdom, correct?
Amen.
Amen. In other words, we want to be spiritually mature about it. We want to be not immature, but mature Christians.
Amen.
And know that whatever he's going to give us, he will give us.
Amen.
We are not going to doubt. His wisdom, in other words, he's going to give the wisdom that you've asked for. He's going to give it to you lavishly. He's going to lavish it on you. Like, all I can think of is a rain, and it's just drenching you like the oil that comes, like on Aaron's beard. It's going to flow to you. That wisdom is going to be used mightily in your life. And that wisdom is going to keep you out of trouble. It's going to keep you out of trouble. Because he's going to say, you say, Donald, should I go clubbing tonight? No. In the name of Jesus, no. You're going to use that wisdom to know what situation you should be in, who you should be talking to, who you shouldn't be. This is all the wisdom that he's going to give you. When we go through trials, what's our attitude? Do we complain? Lord, I can't take this no more. Lord, that's it. I'm done with them. No. Nope. Then he tells me when I start acting out in the flesh, pray for them.
Yes. Amen.
Pray for those who persecute you. Pray for those who say they hate you. Pray for those who refuse to speak to you at my job. All because of who I represent, which is management, or who I represent even more, which is Jesus.
Amen.
So, I want you to think about that. The next time you go through a trial, is your first word out of your mouth a complaint?
Amen.
Or is it, praise you, Jesus.
Amen.
Praise you, Jesus. Amen. I don't know what this is, Lord, but guess what? If I'm being attacked, Lord, I know you're with me because you said you never leave me nor forsake me, Lord.
Amen.
Have faith. Have faith. He's going to get you through it. Again, in verse 4, we lack nothing. If any of you lack wisdom, again, ask God. He is going to give generously to you. It will be given to you. Again, you must believe and not doubt. You don't want to become one who's like the wave of the sea, go back and forth, back and forth. Well, now I believe him. Oh, today I don't know. Today I do. Oh, no. He don't want to hear that.
Amen.
He don't want to hear that. Amen. He don't want to hear that come out of your mouth. He can't use you. Can I just say, I'm going to be blunt. He can't use you like that. He can't use a double-minded Christian.
Amen.
Be single-minded on the Lord. Just focus. Focus on him. Stand still and just be immovable.
Amen.
This is what God told me. I'm going to stay right here. I ain't moving. I ain't going nowhere. Right, Donald?
Amen.
I ain't going nowhere. I'm going to stand on the word. What he told me. And again, that's a mature Christian. I'm not saying there's false faith versus true faith. I'm saying you would be immature if you doubt.
Amen.
You just need to walk it out.
Amen.
You need to walk it out. You need to walk it out and understand that he has the best for you.
Amen.
That he has, he's got your life in his hands.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I know my time is short, so I don't want to, I'm just trying to see, did I miss, amen?
Amen.
Amen. In other words, I guess from all this is you want to be used of God.
Amen.
You want to be used. You don't want to have no value before him. You want to make sure that you're not destroyed by all these doubts.
Yeah.
You want to make sure that you are centered on him and believe in him. And believe me, just have faith. Just say, Lord, I have faith. You can even ask him, can you increase my faith, Lord, because I don't feel it right now.
Amen.
And he's going to do that for you.
Amen.
He will not withhold that from his child. He will never do that. Again, in 2 Corinthians 5:7, it says, we live by faith and not by sight. We live by faith and not by sight. In Mark 11:22, it says that have faith in God. And Jesus said to this person, have faith in God. Just have faith in God.
Amen.
That's a simple, like a children's prayer. I have faith.
Amen.
I have faith. So anyway, Hebrews 11:6, I can close with this. Without faith, it is what? Impossible to be well pleasing to him. For he who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those who seek him.
Amen.
All right, rewarders, amen.